my mother, my grandmother, my grandfather are all members of the stolen generation, and it's a time to reflect on, you know, what they went through during their time. And we all carry scars, you know, emotional scars of what, you know, my mother went through, what my grandmother went through. And, you know, we've certainly come a long way as a First Nations people. We've got a huge amount of successful people in the area of your industry, the sporting, the arts, the music, and there's a lot to celebrate. But at the same time, it's a time to reflect on, you know, the resilience of our mob, you know, that that woke up every day and wanted to live for the next day. And there's the things that we need to reflect on. And we've certainly come a long way, but it's certainly a long way to go. And, you know, you got the Closing the Gap report that was released yesterday. Today marks an anniversary of the Stolen Generation. So, you know, we're pretty amazing people, Natalie, I have to say. And, you know, it's a time for us, I think, to revisit those memories and continue to share the stories to our children.
You mentioned yesterday's Close the Gap report. Can I ask, what were your overall impressions and how confident are you that we can close the gap by 2031?
Well, I think this is a new government and they've got all these intentions that they want to provide jobs. You've got, you know, Mr. Scullion saying there's this huge 23 million invested into truancy officers. With me, and I had a number of interviews yesterday with Ken White, why we say, great, it's your truancy officers are going to get kids to school, but, you know, we've got a government in the Northern Territory that has cut an enormous amount of financial funding out of the education bucket. And where it's hurt us most is in those rural and remote schools where, you know, you and I both know that Indigenous kids are already behind the eight ball in education. So in one area we're saying, let's close a gap, but they're cutting the essential services that need to be there to be put in place to close the gap.
Labor has been pushing for a justice target in the Close the Gap initiative. Were you disappointed that this wasn't added?
Absolutely. And people who are going to prison, they're there for small crimes. They're there because the system in place doesn't give them anything else but, you know, a prison's the only way that you should be sort of the direction you should be heading in. And it's disturbing when you see how much money is spent on the prison. And yet, you know, for example, Naja gave a report the other day and it costs $200,000 a year to keep a juvenile child in Don Dale. $200,000 for one kid. And yet they're pulling resources from other areas, like they had a very successful girls engagement mentoring program at school. That costs less than $200,000 to run. So they're pulling those areas out, yet let's expand the prisons. It's not good enough. It's a national shame that we as a First Nations people, that's the only option that these people are putting on the table at the moment.